Hi, you guys. This is Good Deeds, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday. You know, we actually somewhere. We always hanging out in Atlanta because the thing is, what we do is we try to help you shine your light to the world. And that is your dreams, goals, the purpose, the actual reason you were created, okay? So that's what we do at Good Deeds. And we're actually, we have a beautiful, I mean, just very humble young lady with us. I mean, I cannot express the joy, the laughter I have, because she makes me laugh, but she's very serious on her purpose. And we want to welcome LaTanya Baker to Good Deeds. How you doing?
I'm fine. How about yourself?
Oh, she's just so beautiful. I'm going to make sure she's going to have me looking fantastic and fabulous more than I am. But we want to start a conversation because you just are so joyful. You actually are truly in your purpose. So tell us, I mean, you know how we gonna get this, as the kids said, the skinny. Tell us what makes you feel joyful, what makes brings the light out of you.
The fact that God has given me purpose, and the fact that he's given me a chance over and over again, he's so forgiving. I've had my share of mistakes, I've made my share of mistakes, I've had my flaws. But one day I asked myself, what is my purpose? I didn't, you know, working jobs that I didn't like. I said, this is not what I was designed to do. So let me do something different. And I asked, I said, what is my purpose? About 5 years ago, my mom passed unexpected. And when she passed, I was so hurt. I was angry at God. But then a couple of days later, I said, you know, you don't make any mistakes. And something good has to come out of this. A glory has to come out of this. And I started seeking God more. I started praying. And my sister ended up opening a boutique, Tyrese Boutique, and named it after my mom. She was really passionate about fashion. I love fashion, but didn't know I was passionate about it. And when I saw that she was having fun doing it, I said, I think I want to do that. In high school, I was always doing the plays and the different shows and stuff like that. So I combined my love for fashion with my love for doing events. I asked myself all the time, and 5 years later after her death, I said to myself, you know what, God, you have a sense of humor, because had she not passed, I don't know what I would be doing. You know, of course, I would love to have her with me now. But I know that she's in heaven looking down on us. I know that she's proud of us. And everything that we do, you know, we do in honor of the queen that she is. So I just try to remember that. I try to remember what she instilled in me. My vision, I'm still my sister's keeper. It's a testimony of what I've gone through in life. What I saw my mom go through. I saw her work 2 or 3 jobs, struggle, never married. I saw obesity in my family. People in my family passing from heart attacks and just all type of things. And at some point I said, you know what, it's time to break the cycle. So that brings me to where I am now.
Wow. I have to go back a little, because you said so many amazing things in your journey. You know, because one thing is grief. Grief is, you know, me being a grief counselor, we can talk about this pretty extensive. But I want to ask, because so many people, one thing, grief can be, of course, when someone passes away. It can be when you lose your job. And people know my testimony. I went from 6 figures to 0 in one day in my field of anesthesia. But the thing about it is, speak on that. I'm not trying to put you on the spot on this, but whatever you're going through that's a difficult situation, I feel, can be a form of grief. And I know everybody, you know, it goes through different. But in your case, and you said it already, but I just want to make that point. What helped you go through that process, and you found that light bulb experience, meaning that you actually was going to go through the process? You weren't going to actually allow it to stop you in your purpose.
I turned to God. I increased my faith, and I've learned that I had to learn that I can't stop. I can't keep dealing with my problems myself. I don't care how I try to deal with them. Until I give it to God, it's not going to work out the way that I think it should work out. I've learned to ask him, you know, what do you want from me, and not tell him what I want. When it comes to dating, when it comes to just the way that I live my life, when it comes to making, you know, business decisions, I made a lot of mistakes in the first year. I was excited. I was too nice to people. I didn't know how to say no. So I'm learning that it's okay to say no. I'm learning that, you know, people are going to treat your business the way you treat it. So with everything negative that goes on in my life, I look at it and I say, okay, God, why is this happening and what's going to come of it? You know, what do you need me to do? So I take my pain and I turn it into a passion, or I turn it into a strength. Because if you don't, you'll break down. I mean, I did break down. I'm not going to say I did break down. And I was telling myself, you know, this is not going to happen. I'm going to be this, I'm going to be that. And not knowing that I was speaking so much negativity into my life. And then I just turned all that around. A good friend of mine just told me recently, you know, start doing the opposite of what you have been doing, and you'll see, you know, a difference. And I started doing that same day. And like I said, just being too nice. I've been selling for less for a long time. I just realized maybe a year ago what my worth was, you know, and that some people never realize that. I've had a lot of women inbox me and contact me and say, you know, thank you. I would have never thought that as a plus size I could do this or I could do that, or as a woman I could do this and I could do that. We as women, we take on so much. Yes. We forget about ourselves. You know, we worry about the family. We worry about the men in our lives. You know, we just forget about ourselves. And I'm one. I've lost myself. And so I promise myself that I have to now find myself. And I have to be a testimony, you know, for someone else. A lot of times we don't realize that what we're going through is not even for us. It's to probably save somebody else's life. And that's what I'm learning. You know, this is not even just all about me. One day I'll be able to sit down and tell a woman, you know what you went through, I went through that, and this is how I got through it. So someone sat me down and told me the same thing. You have to just believe in yourself and know that, okay, this is going on right now, so maybe it's just not for me, or maybe I'm gonna get something out of it. And that's just what I've been doing. I've been smiling so much lately because I can finally just, I'm finding myself.
Wow.
You know, I have just been existing for the past couple of years and doing what I thought others wanted me to do. But now I'm doing what I know I want to do, and people are kind of just falling in place. So,
wow, I have to ask it, because, you know, that's my thing, this, you know, being in your purpose. Mm-hmm. So many of us, like you said, mm-hmm. as women, and I think a lot of us, even men, can attest to this, that we do what mom and dad wanted us to do, or we do what our girlfriends and stuff mm-hmm. want us to do. How did you end up, and I know you had the passing of your mom, mm-hmm. but how did you make that bend, that turn, that you say, wait a minute, I think I can do this even with all I have going on in my life? That, I mean, that's a testament to do that, mm-hmm. because I think so many people, and I'm going to say especially women, we can't get out of that valley. And that valley is knowing that we are beautiful, right. and we're wonderfully made, that we can do whatever we put our mind to. Give us a couple of hints on that. I know, of course, God is the forefront of your life,
right.
but, you know, practically, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
When I get up in the morning, I should do this. You know what I'm saying? Tell us a little bit about the things that actually have really motivated and empowered you in your journey.
Well, first of all, I have a lot of inspiring people in my life. A pastor told me about 2.5 years ago, he said, don't get comfortable with the people that are in your life right now. They're just a season. And he said, I know right now it looks like, oh, they have my back and they're this, they're rooting for me. He said, don't get comfortable with that, because God is about to send you a whole new ram of people. And I'm just like, what is this man talking about? And he said, the people that you think are going to support you are not going to support you. He said, but get this. He said, you're going to have to help them one day, and help them. And I'm thinking, like, what is this man talking about? And, you know, after he said what he said to me, I went back to my seat and I got a text message from someone that I had been friends with for a very long time. And the text message, I didn't understand what she was saying. I'm just like, I thought you were happy for me. And I said, wow, God, like, I didn't expect it to happen so fast. Like I said, my mom, what happened with her was the reason that my vision surfaced. My mom passed in her sleep when she was about 52. Her mom passed in her sleep when she was 45. And her mom's mom passed in her sleep when she was about 50. So for me, I was scared to go to sleep for a long time. It was scary. But I started thinking about, we tend to turn into our parents. My mom didn't know how to say no to people. I didn't realize that my mom was stressed out because she was always helping everybody. I mean, people living with her, helping people and their kids. She had a daycare, and half the time people didn't want to pay her for watching their kids, but she was so passionate about taking care of people that she continued to do it. When her mom died at a young age, she was 17 and pregnant with me, so she had to help raise 13 siblings. So she's been a mother, a nurturing mother, since she was 17. So I said to myself, she didn't even get a chance to really live her life. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. She was always taking care of everybody, and I found myself becoming that person.
Wow.
And so I said to myself, my mom died taking care of everybody but herself. Mm-hmm. So I said, I can't go out like that.
Wow.
I can't do it. And I said, I'm pretty sure that she would want more for me. Mm-hmm. And so that's what I did with that. I keep reminding myself of what she went through. Don't get me wrong, she was a beautiful woman. She lived a good life, always happy, always worried about everybody else. She was like the glue to our family. And I'm always being told, you're the glue to the friendship, you're the glue to the family, you're the glue to this. So I'm my mom 110%.
Wow, yes.
But I'm taking what she went through and I'm breaking the cycle. Mm-hmm. Each generation is supposed to get better. It's not supposed to stay the same.
Right.
It's not supposed to get worse. And in the Black community, it's staying the same or it's getting worse.
Right.
And at some point, it has to change. And that's just where I'm at. I have a huge supportive family. My family, wherever I do a show, they will drive here. They're here for me. They're always rooting for me. You know, when my mom passed, it affected so many people in my family because everybody was used to her calling, saying, good morning, let's do this, let's get together. And when she died, a lot of that stopped because everybody was so hurt. Everybody was like, how are we going to fill this void? I mean, people were going through depression. I didn't realize how many people depended on my mom, mm-hmm. including me. Mm-hmm. I was used to my mom, when I call and say, look, this is going on, she would say, girl, God going to take care of it. And I'm like, why are you always so sure of that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and every time I go through something, I hear in my ear, girl, God going to take care of it.
Right.
So I live by that.
Oh,
I live by that. So just, you know, in a nutshell, just looking at the life that she lived, looking at how she allowed people to continue to walk all over her. My aunt said at her funeral, my sister would fall down and the very people that stuck their foot out to trip her would walk on her when she fell, and she would get back up, dust herself off, and grab those same people by the hand and still help them. And that was my mom, and that was me. And I mean, I would think about that. I'm like, oh my God, I'm just like her. My family tells me all the time, you are just like your mother. You know, you have to start saying no. You have to start being so, you know, so kind-hearted. Don't change being kind to people, but just, you know, ease up a little bit. So that's what I'm doing, and it's hard.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I hate to see people struggle. You know, I hate to see people go without, but I'm doing it in a different way now. You know, instead of putting myself in a situation where it's inconvenient for me, I'm praying with people. I'm providing them with resources so that they know how to get it themselves. You know, one day I want to open up an organization where I'm so passionate about helping women. You know, I love our men too, but I feel like we're the backbone for everything. And I feel like if we lift each other up, then in return, we can help lift them up. So, you know, one day I'm going to open up an organization where I can help a homeless woman or a woman that, you know, was abused or was raped. And she just felt like, you know, my life is over with. No, it's not. There's always room for hope. So let me help you. So that's just where I'm at.
I'm so proud of you. Latoya, you just make my soul just bubble, because that's the thing about it, is it's okay to be transparent. And I am an audience, y'all know I am. But the thing is, people learn from your testimony,
things that
you do, the nuggets that you've learned, so that's deep in your soul from your mother, the things that you've just told us, even with grief.
Yeah.
And you know, and that's the thing, ladies and gentlemen, I want to let you know that everybody grieves different.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, the thing is, our healthcare professionals, our counselors are very important to your walk, because the thing is, the most important thing is to be able to get those emotions out, to get those feelings out. And the thing is, sometimes you have to do counseling, group counseling. You have to, you know, get books and those things like that. And if you, you know, if you need some information about that, please contact us. And if you don't have anything local, we'll find a place, okay? But, you know, we really enjoying this conversation. But what we're going to do is, please agree to stay with us. Mm-hmm. We're going to take a little break, and we want to come back because we want to know how to put our wardrobes together that we actually feel special, that we feel proud, and we actually, that's inside and actually out. Because you've helped us so much with our inner beauty of the things that we have been stopping us a little bit. Mm-hmm. But now we want to talk a little bit more of how we can put them all together. Will you agree to stay with us for a little bit, Latoya? Ooh, ladies and gentlemen, we're having a ball. You know, this is my area, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to take a little commercial break. We'll take a little break, and we'll be right back. You know, this is Good Deeds, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday. Hi, you guys. This is Good Deeds, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday. We're back. You know we're having an amazing conversation. By this time, you sent out the tweets, you sent out the Facebook, all this kind of stuff, email, call, text, whatever you guys do. So, oh, I forgot Snapchat, right? The things that you do to share the information, because this is a power pack. You thought you were just going to get fashion information, but actually we have gotten wisdom, life nuggets that we can apply to our life right now. And we actually still have the beautiful Latoya with us. But welcome back to the second session of Good Deeds. How you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Good. I just thank you so much for being in your purpose. But we want to get into, because, you know, we want to look all cute, all the different holidays, birthdays, and anniversaries coming up. Just tell us a little bit more about your boutique. I just love it.
Sure. The boutique name again is after my mom, Tyresia's Boutique 2. We are online. Basically what we do, we style women from small size to all the way to plus size, so small to 3X. I'm actually getting into customizing clothes too, where I'll actually start making my clothes. Right now I purchase wholesale and I just resell the clothes. But basically just allow women to feel good about themselves. When you put on a new dress or, you know, anything, makeup and hair and this, that, it just makes you feel some type of way.
Yes.
So I used to always get compliments at work. Oh my God, that looks nice. Or where did you get that from? So I said, you know what? Let people start asking me that so I can tell them I got it from me.
Oh,
so
wow.
That's where, like, you know, it. The boutique idea came up. But like I said, my sister opened up the first boutique. She and I both, my mom, we always liked to dress. So I'm like, why don't we just, you know, open up a boutique? And that's where I'm at. So I just love to look beautiful and help others look beautiful as well. Enhance your beauty, because we're all beautiful. Just, it enhances your beauty.
Wow. Well, let me ask you this, because, you know, I've heard of a lot of boutiques, how they, you know, how they have it set up. You know, sometimes you can bring your girlfriend in with you, your husband come if he want to, you know, a boyfriend. But when we come in, you know, because, of course, we have to have the right undergarments. Mm-hmm. You know, some women look better in, you know, flared, and some look pencil. I mean, how do you know? Because the thing, I'm one of those ladies. I'm gonna let the cat out the bag. A lot of times, you have to tell me what I look good in. Mm-hmm. Now, I can look at something that somebody else have on, and I can say, "Ooh, wonder how I look in that." But how do you actually? I know it's your gift, but how do you kind of put it together? Because some women are insinuated, mm-hmm. you know, or have bigger curves or, you know, different structures that need to be accented, okay. and some that need to be lesser. How do you put all that together? Or just even start the conversation.
Well, I get to know their personality. I try to find out, you know, what their personality is. Most time when you go to the store and you're shopping for yourself, you're looking at what the mannequin has on. You're looking at what the people in the store are wearing. So it is all about advertising. So I try to wear my own clothing. I try to also step out the box myself, because I wear black all day. So instead of just wearing black, I try to add like a little bow to it, or, you know, something. I love the flary dresses. I don't wear a lot of the bodycon dresses because mm-hmm. of my size, but I see a lot of plus size women doing that now. So you can kind of, you know, change the colors up, but I start with their personality. What I love to do is when someone tells me, this doesn't look good on me, this doesn't look good on me, I'll have them try it on just to see. Because they've never, most of the time when people say that doesn't look good on me, they haven't even tried it on. to even see if it looks good on them. Mm-hmm. So I'll try to kind of get people to, I love to get people to step out of their shell. I love it. I think I enjoy that more than anything. I have people who are very picky. I love working with picky people. I love a challenge, and that gives me a challenge. But just getting to know their personality. I know, you know, when I ask you, you know, what is it that you like? Do you like colors? You gave me a lot of options, so I love options. You didn't say, don't put me in this and don't put me in this and don't put me. I'm like, well, that's just a sheet then if you want to wear it. I mean, we got to put you in something. But yeah, just getting to know the personality and, you know, what they like and what they don't like, and trying to get people to kind of open up and, mm-hmm. you know, try different options.
Now, I have to make a confession. Everything was in my closet was black, you know, pants, black dresses, black shoes, mm-hmm. before I actually got in media. So it was really, the way I look at it as a flower blooming, mm-hmm. when I actually became in media, because I really didn't realize that I looked good in red, that I looked good, right. in different, like burnt orange and stuff like that. But the thing that I want to ask is, if you see someone that's kind of shy, mm-hmm. but you know in your heart they look good in these reds and this stuff, and then now everybody's having the blouses and shirt, yeah. that go all the way up here, and it's just so changing. And I know you, like you said, you get to know our personality, but do you spend, you know, because I know time is money, but that conversation that you would have with somebody, especially like me, that I need to get out of black, I need to actually mm-hmm. do the reds, because now I'm unstoppable, because I can actually be in those different colors, because it brings out my personality.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to say this, even though my boutique is online, I did have a little showroom at my house. And what I found out when women came to my house, they were so comfortable with trying new things in that type of setting. It was still a little boutique area, but it was still the home feeling. So when I do open up a boutique on a storefront, I wanted to have that type of feeling where you're in your girlfriend's house and you're just having tea or girl talk and this and that, and you're just trying on clothes. I have customers sometimes that come over and they're there for like 4 hours. We're just talking.
I love it.
And they're just opening up and we're crying and we're trying on clothes, and next thing you know, they have a bag full of clothes because they didn't think that they could wear this. And that wasn't my plan. Of course, I want to, you know, make money and sell clothes, but my plan was that, hey, they want to try this one dress on that they saw on my website. Now they have about 6 or 7 dresses because we've talked about this, we've talked about that. Black, a lot of people, for me, I'm going to speak for me, black helps us hide, but black can also be bold. So it depends, mm-hmm. on how you wear it. You know, you can wear black and then you can wear some, you know, big earrings with gold and this and that. But a lot of people, you know, from my experience, wore black because it helps them hide themselves. I'm the type of person, I like to be behind the scenes and make things happen. Now, you know, even with my insecurities, I'm coming on the forefront and I'm being in my own pictures, I'm being in my own videos, doing interviews and all that. I used to let the models do the interviews, and I was just behind directing. You know, now I'm coming out because everybody's like, well, who is Teresa's Boutique too? Here she is, I'm back here. Now you can see who Teresa's Boutique is too, because I'm getting over my insecurities. I'm breaking the cycle. So basically just creating an atmosphere where people can feel comfortable. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when they're walking in the door, they're like, and she's not going to put me on this and she's not going to put me on that. But by the time they leave, they're like, now this girl done talked me into buying this. And I really didn't talk you into it. I just helped you see that, hey, try this, you know, mm-hmm, what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I love it. I'm learning. I want to go now to that place. But you know, I love that you do have that home feel, because that actually, you're right, it will help, mm-hmm. us come out. But you actually are part of major events as well.
Yes, ma'am.
So tell us about that.
This is, I'm still My Sister's Keeper's second annual fashion show. It has actually become a movement. Someone texted me, she said, do you realize that your show is now a movement? And I said, you know what? I've been thinking about that. I said, now that you say it, she said, you have to do more than what you're doing. You can't just do a fashion show anymore. So we have been putting together different events. We did like a little selfie campaign where women took pictures of themselves, and then they did a hashtag, I'm still My Sister's Keeper, the city and state that they were from, and then breaking the cycle. Each year we change the theme. Last year we brought awareness to domestic violence.
Oh, wow.
We had a domestic violence shelter there giving out information, and we gave like clothing to them for the women in the shelter. This year the theme was breaking the cycle. I was having a conversation with one of the designers one night, and I said, I was so scared to do the show this year. You know how you have with what, well, I'm not gonna say you, but you know how a person comes out with an album and their album is just, it's a hit. But then it's like, okay, now what am I gonna do with this sophomore album? And they get scared. They're like, I have to top this first one. And that's how I was. I'm like, okay, I had a great show last year. Mm-hmm. How am I gonna top that? Mm-hmm. So I said, I'm not even gonna do it. I was backing out. And wow. The people that I called to tell them, they were like, no, you are going to do it. You can't start something big like that and just end it. So I'm like, okay. And when I tell you, I started talking about it, people started texting me and inboxing me, what do you need me to do this year? I said, you know what, God, I'm going to do it. So my good friend, Wena Holt, she got blessed with this building. I didn't know where I was going to get the money from to rent an event hall, and she was like, sis, oh my God, I got this building, and she's screaming, oh, and wow, she's happy about it. It has my dance studio, it has this. I'm like, cool. She was like, have the show here. I'm like, are you kidding me? She was like, yes. So here we are. Wow. Like I said, it's become a movement. It's becoming bigger and bigger. People are talking about it every day, posting videos. We just did such an emotional video with Mark Squared a couple weeks ago. I told them, you know, what I wanted to happen, and they made it come to life. And as the women were talking about some of the things that they were going through, I was getting so emotional, because when you see these women now, you're looking like, you went through that?
Wow, okay.
And the way they carry themselves, you wouldn't think that they had experienced that. Mm-hmm. And with me going through some of the stuff that I went through, it's like, so if she got through that, I know I can get through this. And that's what the vision is all about. You know, being, wow. I think we as women, because we take on so much, we forget about each other. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And if we just...
We think we all alone.
Yeah. We think we're all alone. That's it. You know, if we break the cycle and we start talking about it, mm-hmm, and we are there for each other and stop beating each other down, like we can be, this can become so much bigger. Oh. I've worked in call center environments for a very long time. And, you know, it's known that call center environments, they have a negative mentality. And mm-hmm, I've experienced just so much negativity in the call center environment. And I called one of my friends one day and I said, I want to walk out of this job. I said, you know, I'm happy about what God is doing in my life. And I said, but other people in my job are kind of looking like, oh, she thinks she's all that. I said, I don't think I'm all that. And she said, look, you have a vision. I'm still my sister's keeper. Do you think it's going to come easy? It's not going to be easy. She said, God has you there for a reason.
That's right.
You have to let your light shine, and you have to show them what I'm still my sister's keeper all about. Yeah, you're talking about me when I walk past. Yeah, you're looking at me rolling my eyes, mm-hmm, but I'm going to show you what being I'm still my sister's keeper is
what
all about.
Really all
yeah,
about.
And I did that. And I'm telling you, within a matter of 2 weeks, I started seeing a difference. And I was just like, okay. Okay, wow. God, I got you.
I got you.
But
oh, wow. I love it. Well, tell us how we can be a part of your upcoming event, and how sure, we can, you know, of course we need to know how we can support you and how we can support you on social media networks as well.
Purchase tickets. We have a fashion show on March 26th at Elevu's Den & Dance Studio. It's at 2483. I may say the street name wrong. Delowe, D-E-L-O-W-E, Drive. Mm-hmm. And that's in Atlanta, Georgia. It's going to start, it's on a Sunday, so it'll start early from 6 p.m. until 9 p.m. And the unique thing about this show this year, we're not just going to do your average fashion. We're going to do African fashion. We're going to go to the 1930s, the 60s, 70s, 80s, and bring it all the way up until today's fashion. So each designer has been given an assignment to do some research on fashion from those fashion eras, but it can be fashion you can wear today. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna focus, March is Women's Month, if you don't know that. So we're gonna talk about women's history. One of the fashion eras is the 1970s that Lifestyle Plus, Keisha Talley is gonna do. She probably has the biggest job out of anybody, because we're gonna hit Black Lives Matter. We're gonna talk mm-hmm, about that. Mm-hmm. Some of the women are going to pretty much share some of what they went through, but it's going to be in a fashion sense. So I can't wait. I don't like doing basic. I don't like doing normal. Whatever I do, I like to go out all out and do it big. But I used to be so nervous about talking about what I want because it was so big in my head. But I'm like, if I say it, is it really going to come out like that? Yeah. So when I started talking about it, everybody was like, oh my God, I love that. I'm like, really? So, I mean, I can't wait.
Wow.
I was telling my assistant, Sonia, about what was going on. And she was like, you came up with the idea? She was like, yeah. She was like, oh my God. I mean, it's one thing for you to be excited about your vision, mm-hmm. but to hear others be excited about that, that's worth more than anything.
That's true.
Worth more than anything. And for people to tell me, I love your vision. I love this. This lady inboxed me. She said, do you have any t-shirts? I'm like, you know what? Good idea.
Well, no. Do you take information from everybody? But we actually here at Good Deeds, we commend you, one, for being your purpose, and then the things you do, and we support you in the things
Thank you.
We've had a great time. Oh, I'm just bubbling over. I may have to get my old modeling skills out. Okay, I hear y'all. I still got it, okay? But we want to thank you so much.
Thank you.
For being here with us on Good Deeds. Latoya, oh, you just made my, she just made me feel just special. I just thank you for everything. Woo, Lord. We just have had a power-packed session, and I just don't even know. I know we got to get off, but Lord, tell us what your information on Facebook one more time.
On Facebook, my personal page is Latoya Ferguson Baker. My business page is Tyrese's Boutique 2. We also have an I'm Still My Sister's Keeper page for the fashion show. So you can find me on all those social media outlets. I'm on Instagram as Tyrese's Boutique 2. All together is Tyresias Boutique and then T-O-O.
I love it. Ooh, Latoya Baker, thank you so much for being here with
Thanks
us on Good
me.
Deeds. Ooh, ladies and gentlemen, you know we bring you great information, things that, you know, to educate you, motivate you, and inspire you, that we can all go forward in our destiny. You know how to contact us. You know, for anything that you need, the things that we do and the things that we do that you need to let us know that you need. Because, you know, if I don't know the answer, guess what? We're going to find it, okay? Our website is www.renee, which is RENEESunday.com, and all our social media information is right there on the website, so you click and go there. But you know, I always have to say this before we close. You do have a purpose. You do have a reason that, one, you were born. You have a reason that you're here right now. You got to do the three things. You got to believe, you got to trust, and you got to walk it out. This is Good Deeds, and I'm Dr. Renee Sunday. See you next time. Bye-bye.